Are you struggling to understand how capacitors work in different circuits? Hey guys, in today's video, we're diving into the fascinating world of capacitors, exploring how they work both in series and parallel configurations. Stick around because we've got some practical examples that will make these concepts crystal clear. Let's start with capacitors in parallel. Imagine you have a 9-volt battery connected to two capacitors in parallel. The first capacitor, C1, is 10 microfarads, and the second one, C2, is 100 microfarads. How do we determine the total or equivalent capacitance in this parallel circuit? In a parallel configuration, the equivalent capacitance is simply the sum of all the individual capacitances. The total capacitance formula in a parallel configuration is C total equals C1 plus C2 and so on. In our example, we add 10 microfarads and 100 microfarads, giving us a total of 110 microfarads. Now let's talk about the charge stored in these capacitors. In a parallel circuit, the voltage across each capacitor is the same as the battery voltage, which is 9 volts in our case. To find the charge stored in a capacitor, we use the formula Q equals to C times V, where C is the capacitance of the capacitor in farad, and V is the voltage across the capacitor in volts. For C1, that's 10 microfarad times 10 to the minus 6, since we need this value to be in farad. Times 9 volts equals 0.09 coulomb. For C2, it's 100 microfarad times 10 to the minus 6 times 9 volts equals 0.009 coulomb. Adding these together, the total charge stored in the circuit is 0.0099 coulomb. Next, let's calculate the energy stored in each of the capacitors. The formula for the energy stored in a capacitor is E equals to 1/2 times C times V squared, where C is the capacitance of the capacitor in farad, and V is the voltage across the capacitor in volts. For C1, it is 1/2 times 10 microfarad times 10 to the minus 6, since we need this value to be in farad times 9 to the power of 2. The energy stored in C1 is 0.0405 joules or 0.405 millijoules. For C2, it is 1/2 times 100 microfarad times 10 to the minus 6 times 9 to the power of 2. The energy stored in C2 is 0.0405 joules or 4.05 millijoules. To demonstrate the effects of the energy stored in a capacitor, I will attach an LED to the circuit. I will use a 450 ohm resistor in front of the LED to limit the current through the LED. Be sure to check my other video if you want to learn how I calculated the resistance. As shown, the LED lights up when the circuit is closed. When the circuit is opened, the LED lights up temporarily as it draws on the stored charge from the capacitors. Now let's move on to capacitors in series. In this circuit, I have a battery with 9 volts and two capacitors in series. C1 is 10 microfarads and C2 is 100 microfarads. How do we find the total capacitance in this series circuit? In a series configuration, the total capacitance is found using the reciprocal formula 1 over C1 plus 1 over C2 and so on. For our example, this becomes 1 over 10 plus 1 over 100. Solving this, we get a total capacitance of approximately 9.09 microfarads. In a series circuit, the charge on each capacitor is the same, but the voltage across each capacitor can differ. To find these voltages, we first calculate the total charge using Q equals to the total charge times the battery voltage. For our circuit, 9.09 microfarads times 10 to the minus 6 times 9 volts equals 0.008181 coulomb, or 81.81 microcoulombs. To find the voltage across each capacitor, we use V equals to Q divided by C. For C1, that's 81.81 microcoulombs divided by 10 microfarads equals to 8.18 volts. For C2, it's 81.81 microcoulombs divided by 100 microfarads equals to 0.8181 volts. For a demonstration of capacitors in series, I will attach a resistor and an LED in series. When the circuit is closed, the LED doesn't light up. Why? Don't miss part 2 of this series, where I explain and demonstrate capacitors in series and parallel using a breadboard. The link is in the video description. If you enjoyed this explanation of capacitors in series and parallel, don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and ring that bell icon so you won't miss out on my upcoming videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time.